soon as he see the time that you were in, my friend, it's okay. Just take your life easy and stop all that hurry and be happy my way. When tension starts mounting and you've lost count of the pennies you missed, just try hard to see why they're not worrying me, the last on my list. Nothing's easy. We'll be right back. chances, and your reputation's going down, going out in the night time. You think you make no sound, but you don't fool me, 'cause I know what you feel. If you ignore the things I say, someday soon's gonna find you way down a beggar's farm. Way down a beggar's farm. I pay my money for no returns. I don't think I need you. I'm gonna find someone. But you don't fool me, 'cause I know what you feel. If you ignore the things I say, someday soon's gonna find you way down a beggar's farm. Way down a beggar's farm. Good evening, nice to see you. Hello! Whoa. Thanks very much indeed. That was Beggar's Farm from the very first Jethro Tull album in 1968. Before that was Nothing Is Easy from 1969. This next one is one of those more acoustic songs that marked out our early single releases. I think this was 1970, 71, somewhere around there, piece. It's really my waking up in the morning song. About waking up in the morning. I like to wake up in the morning as often as possible. It's called Life is a Long Song. When you're falling awake and you take stock of the new day, and you hear your voice croak as you choke on what you need to say. Well, don't you fret, don't you fear, I will bring you good cheer. Life's a long song, life's a long song, life's a long song, yeah. If you wait on your plate, I will fail. As the verses unfold and your soul suffers the long day, and the 12 o'clock gloom spins the room, you struggle on your way. Well, don't you sigh, don't you cry, lick the dust from your eye. Life's a long song, life's a long song, life's a long song, yeah. We will meet in the sweet light of dawn, as a Vegas tree train spills your pain all over your new dress, and the symphony sounds underground with you and the duress. Well, don't you squeal as a heel rides here under the wheels. Life's a long song, life's a long song, life's a long song, yeah. But the tune ends too soon for a song. I'm an angry guy, you know, that's what keeps me going, because there's lots of things in this world to be really angry about. If I wasn't angry about the Middle East and Palestine and Israel, if I wasn't angry about Iran or North Korea, if I wasn't angry about lots of
aspects of conservation, if I wasn't angry about the fact that no one wants to talk about population on planet Earth. I'm angry. Of course I'm angry. That's what drives me on stage. You know, it's a lot of it's fun and humorous, and but there's also a lot of anger there. And I think you have to be, you have to have some strong emotions. And for me, if you ever meet me and I'm not angry, then you can assume I'm probably going to die tomorrow. Because I think, you know, I have an inner anger and an inner concern, and that's what drives me. But I'm not like that all the time, but, you know, it's 24 hours in the day. I only have to be angry for 23 of them. Oh, no, I have really angry dreams. I kill people in my dreams. I couldn't do it in real life, but I often have dreams where I actually kill people. I usually shoot them.
A legendás Jethro Tull együttes 1967-ben alakult a nagy-britanniai Lutonban. Zenéjét Ian Anderson páratlan éneklési stílusa, virtuóz fuvola játéka és a meglehetősen szokatlan dalszerkesztés jellemzi. Klasszikus kelta és art rock elemeket kever. Anderson, aki különleges figura, annak tulajdonítja a Jethro Tull egyedülálló hangzását, hogy a zenekar tagjai sohasem fogyasztottak semmilyen kábítószert. A 70-es évek közepére a Jethro Tull a világ egyik legsikeresebb együttesévé vált. Olyan ismert és népszerű volt, mint a Led Zeppelin, Elton John vagy a Rolling Stones. A különc és tartózkodó Ian Anderson délnyugat-Angliában él egy farmon, és két gyermeke van. Chili paprikát termeszt, és irodalomból doktorál.
It's a very difficult thing for anyone who is on a stage to know or try to guess what the audience are experiencing. I don't think we can ever know that. And it's good that we don't know that. I don't want to know what people are thinking. You know, I don't go on stage to make everybody happy. I go on stage to make me happy. You know, I want to have a good concert where I feel at the end of it, I did okay. You know, not that I did great, just I did okay. That makes me feel, you know, positive and good. If you go on stage to perform and your whole reason to do it is to make the audience go, wow, isn't he wonderful, then I think that's not a good thing. That's showbiz. That's Las Vegas. You know, and I don't do Las Vegas. I do me. I do what I want to do to make me feel fulfilled. But I'm never completely fulfilled. There's never a perfect concert. Every concert is, you know, it's 60% good, 40% bad, or it's 80% good, 20% bad, but it's never 100% good. That's impossible. But I try every night to try to get closer to that 100%.
Now everything is easy, you find that the squeeze won't turn out so bad. Your fingers be freeze, worst things happen at sea. There's good times to be had. So if you're alone and you're down to the bone, just give us a play. You'll smile in a while and discover that I'll get you happy my way. Nothing's easy.
Well, you know, I'm not sure that God gave me a talent. I think that if we want to talk about God, then I don't believe in an interventionist God. I don't believe in a God who we can pray to say, please send me a big check in the post for a lot of money, or please let my son find a beautiful girl and get married to her and have lots of babies. I don't believe in that kind of God who gives you special favors. And so I don't really think that, I don't really believe in talent. I believe there's a genetic likelihood that you could be, if you work hard and you do what you can when you're younger, then there's a likelihood for some people they can be creative and they can do something useful.
The first time I met Ian Anderson was around 20 years before. I think first they are well classically trained. And then after they extemporize on their music and they build into classic and rock and jazz, building on the classical foundation.